The Automotodrome Renault was the host of the Czech Republic Grand Prix and saw MotoGP back in action after its summer break. Due to difficult weather and subsequent lack of grip, we saw a grand total of 64 crashes throughout the weekend, 17 in MotoGP, 19 in Moto2, and a whopping 28 in Moto3, with turns 3 and 12 seeing the highest number of crashes with 12 apiece. First up, we look to Tom Lutie as he drops the rear end, coming out of turn one and heading into turn two. The rear tyre loses grip and the Swiss rider was very lucky not to high side out of the corner. Next up, it's MotoGP and the left-right chicane of turns 8 and 9 as Danny Pedrosa pushes past the limit of grip on his front tyre and low sides into the gravel trap. Danny, however, was unharmed but quickly back on his motorcycle to get out on track. The downhill hairpin at turn 10 often sees front-end crashes, however Nicolò Buliger rewrote the rulebook in FP3 as he ran offline, lost and quickly regained grip, throwing him from the bike in a spectacular high side. Fortunately, he was unharmed. Same corner but a more traditional low side for Marquez as the Spaniard trail braked but lost the front end before he was fully leaned over for the corner. The bike goes careering into the air fence and it would be a big repair for Repsol Honda. Now it's Ducati's turn to go down at turn 10, not with Lorenzo, but with Alvaro Bautista as he drops the front of its GP16. The Spaniard tumbles through the air as his bike suffers a lot of damage. However, like Marquez, the team had the bike repaired quickly. One turn later in the wet-free practice session on Friday as Franco Morbidelli runs out of grip and slides off the track. Unfortunately for the Italian, his bike digs in and pirouettes through the gravel, causing extensive damage to the Kalex. On board now, and we can see just how little warning Morbidelli had before it all went wrong. However, he walked away unharmed. And finally, the battle for the grid in Q2 saw Pol Espargaró pushing just a bit too hard in turn 12 whilst trying to better his lap time, ending his session in the gravel trap. That was a look at the best crashes from Bruno. We're at the Red Bull Ring in Austria next weekend.